Katherine, and this is my trusty sidekick, Delilah. And today we're going to be talking to you about vaccinations. Firstly, what vaccines you should be giving, if you're going to be giving them at all, when you should be giving them, and also any side effects to be aware of. So our first question is, should you even be vaccinating your dog or puppy? I know there are a lot of people that are quite concerned these days about the side effects of vaccines and also concerned about some of the ingredients that can be put into vaccines. But what I will say as a veterinarian is that I strongly recommend vaccinating your dog and your puppy, at least for the core vaccines. So what I mean by core, well, there tend to be two different types of vaccines that we talk about as veterinarians. The first is the core vaccines, and the second is the non-core vaccines. So core vaccines are what we tend to strongly recommend that every dog be given, unless your dog has a particular medical condition that prevents them from getting vaccinated. And that's something to be talked about with your veterinarian. What do you think, Delilah? I was just gonna go and chill out here. So in terms of the core vaccines, we've got DHPP. That includes distemper. And distemper is a neurological and gastrointestinal disease that thankfully we've actually largely eradicated in many areas because of vaccination, so distemper. The next one is hepatitis, and that is another viral vaccine that causes pretty similar effects to what we see in hepatitis with humans. So that can make them very sick, very jaundiced. Thankfully can often be treated quite well, but definitely a good one to be vaccinating against. The next one is parvovirus, and you may have heard about this one before. It's the nasty one that often puppies get, especially puppies at shelters where it's an intestinal disease. They get a lot of really, really painful bloody diarrhea. The next one is another P, parainfluenza virus, which causes an infection that is similar to influenza, so kind of like a cold, I guess, for dogs. And then the last one of the core vaccines is rabies. And most of us have definitely heard about rabies, and it's actually a very common disease in many parts of the world, although not actually in Australia where I'm from. So rabies is transmissible to humans, so that's why it's particularly important to vaccinate dogs against rabies. And actually a lot of different areas do have regulations requiring that dogs and cats and other animals sometimes be vaccinated. So those are our core ones: distemper, hepatitis, parvovirus, parainfluenza, and rabies. And then we've also got a series of non-core vaccines, and they may or may not be recommended to you depending on where you live and what your veterinarian thinks is best. So definitely something to talk about with your veterinarian depending on your particular puppy or dog circumstances. But those ones tend to be Bordetella, so that's something that helps protect against kennel cough, a very infectious disease that's picked up often when dogs are in close proximity. So that may be boarding kennels or dog parks, even if they've been picked up from a shelter. Another non-core vaccine that you may want to think about with your veterinarian is Lyme disease, which is carried by ticks, so it can be a good one for dogs that go out adventuring in the wilderness. And another one that can be good for those kind of circumstances is leptospirosis, which is carried by wildlife and causes kidney infections in dogs. So now we've covered the core and the non-core vaccines. Now we need to think a little bit about when we're going to give these vaccines. So you may have recently adopted a puppy, and if so, I hope they've at least received their first round of vaccinations. That's often done by a breeder or by the shelter, if you're picking up a dog from a shelter. And these kind of vaccines, the puppy vaccines, should be started between the ages of 6 to 8 weeks. We don't want to be doing that any earlier. The reason being that, actually the same with humans, puppies receive antibodies from their mother's milk. They should be getting a lot of antibodies for all different diseases from their mum's milk, but those antibodies slowly start to decline once they reach around 6 to 8 weeks of age. That's when we give our first vaccine. So we're giving the first puppy vaccine between the ages of 6 to 8 weeks. After that, we want to look at boosting those puppy vaccines at least every 3 to 4 weeks. So that's something to be done at your veterinarian. And I'm sure that they're going to talk to you about the proper protocol to follow. But you want to be thinking that first one, 6 to 8 weeks, followed by 2, sometimes 3, depending on how old they are, every 3 to 4 weeks. And finally, for adults. So once you're puppy has reached adulthood, or you may already have an adult dog on your hands, you want to be looking at vaccinating them every 1 to 3 years. Again, depending on your particular circumstances and the recommendation of your veterinarian, and actually also the type of vaccine. So some vaccines do need to be given every year. Some regions that you live in actually have a requirement that dogs be vaccinated, for example, for rabies every year. And then other vaccines can be given every 3 years. Finally, and this is the one that a lot of people get a little bit worried about when they think about vaccinations, is potential side effects. So this can make a lot of people pretty wary about giving vaccines, but I will say that all side effects in general are quite rare, and they can really range on across a spectrum of severity. So starting with the less severe side effects that we tend to see more commonly is that after you vaccinate a dog, and particularly a puppy, they may get a little bit sleepy for the next 24 hours or so. So if you're noticing them resting a little bit more, that's something that's often expected. They can also lose their appetite a little bit. That's often because they have a little bit of an elevated temperature, so it makes them feel a little bit off. So a bit of lethargy, sleepiness, sluggishness, a little bit off their food, that's all pretty common and nothing we tend to be too worried about. Other side effects can include, look at vomiting, swollen face. Sometimes they can develop difficulty breathing. They might go into shock. They might even start seizuring. All of those side effects are very, very rare, and they will be discussed by your veterinarian when you go in for the vaccinations. Nothing that I would warn pet owners against vaccinating, but something to be mindful of, as you look to make this decision. Again, those worst side effects are all very rare. I've actually never seen them in practice. But if you are worried, even if your dog's only showing very mild signs, maybe they're just not quite themselves, or they've been sleeping a little bit more since you took them home, definitely call your vet or even take them straight into your veterinarian to have them checked out. One last thing I will say about side effects is it's actually a really smart idea to time the time of the vaccine, the day that you're having your pet vaccinated, to ensure that you're actually going to be around at home with them afterwards. So we don't want a situation where you might get them vaccinated at 10 o'clock in the morning and then have to rush straight home to work. Meanwhile, your poor little puppy's at home not feeling that great afterwards. So we just want to make sure that you are around at home in the unlikely scenario that they do have a reaction. So there we go. We've covered what to vaccinate your puppy against, when you should think about doing it, and in any potential side effects to be wary of. Unfortunately, my little sidekick here has since gone to sleep in the sun, and I'll just point you over here. So she's definitely sleeping on the job, but I hope that you had fun with me regardless. Thank you so much for joining us today. And if you have any further questions, please feel free to add a question in the comments below. And lastly, if you want any more dog tips, please subscribe, and I'm going to be uploading new videos every week, Thursday, 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So I hope to see you next time.